Yes, it takes only 5 clicks to self-host n8n, even for a beginner. And you know what's the best part? Hosting in the cloud is much easier than hosting locally on your computer with Docker. Plus, you get unlimited workflows and executions. Sounds like the perfect solution, right? Almost. Watch until the end of this video so you know exactly how to self-host your n8n in under 1 minute and if you should do it or not.
First, navigate to ls.io and click on free trial if you don't already have an account. Otherwise, simply log in. Once logged in, click on create new service, type n8n into the search field and select the corresponding template. Next, choose your preferred provider. For instance, I select this one. The basic version is notably affordable at just $13 per month. Afterwards, select the desired server region and finally, determine the size of your service. For basic automation and testing purposes, the micro plan is certainly sufficient. Moreover, if you later require increased performance, you can easily upgrade your machine without making additional changes. Click Next. Now, you may assign a custom name to your service. However, I will leave it unchanged. Additionally, I'll keep all other options as they are by default. Finally, select your desired support level. At this stage, the included support is undoubtedly adequate. Then simply click on Create Service to start deployment. Once deployment is completed, click on your newly deployed instance. Then select Display Admin UI, and afterwards click on the provided admin UI, URL. Now our self-hosted n8n instance is successfully deployed and running. Finally, fill out the displayed form to create an account for your hosted version. Simply answer the question and we are good to go.
Now your self-hosted n8n is up and running, but we still have not answered the question if it's worth it or not, because there are some crucial downsides. That's why I created 3 simple categories to help you decide if it's good for you or not. And if you stay until the end, I have a pro tip for you that can save you a lot of money. The first category should not self-host at all. That's everybody who is working in a collaboration-heavy team. This is because the community edition is limited only to 1 admin, which restricts crucial collaboration features. The second category is for people who must self-host n8n. That's everybody who is forced by external factors, such as compliance or privacy. The third category is for people who are fine with the limitations of the community edition and want one of the following things: cost savings, no per action billing, no workflow limits, access to community build notes, and if you're privacy driven. That's basically everybody who is a freelancer or hobbyist. Otherwise, you're better off with the hosted version by n8n directly than with your own private cloud, because it's maintained and scales with your needs. And lastly, a pro tip, adopt a hybrid model. That means you use your self-hosted version for the high-volume workflows and the hosted version for collaboration-heavy tasks. That way you get best of both worlds. I hope you found value in this video. If so, I would be incredibly grateful if you smash the like button and subscribe to my channel.